Hi, YouTubers! Phoenix Talon back with you again for another Creativerse tutorial! I know, it's awesome, right? Okay, so where did we go off on the next one? The last one? The place where we were the last time? Okay, so you have no idea what you're looking at. Well, maybe you do. I don't know. But this is going to be our interface for the elevator. Now, you're like, wait a second, what? Huh? What are you talking about? Elevator interface? You mean there's like a thing for that? Isn't it just a number pad? Well, I hate to inform you, it's not just a number pad. No, it requires other stuff. And the wiring is, I don't want to say it's complicated, but it looks worse than it is. So there you go. It's not that bad. It really isn't. And it's actually quite easy to understand. This is just the number selector part going up to here for the floor select. This is what determines whether it's going up or down. And this is an error checker. That's it. Now, you're looking at it going, that's it? Really? I don't get that. That's fine. We're going to do it step by step. As a matter of fact, we're not even going to build this all in one day. We can't. It's impossible. Well, all right, it's possible. But if you know what you're doing. If you don't know what you're doing, this could take a while. So you would think, okay, we're going to start with the number pad and the number comparator. We're not. We're going to start with logic gates. And I have NAND ones here. And I have, where are you, NOR gates, there you are, NOR gates here. And I have to explain what these NAND and NOR gates are doing. Not how they work, because you should know that already. No, I have to explain why they're there. And the reason I need to explain it is that this is crucial. You need to be able to set and reset memory. For example, this says right here that we're going to floor 1. Let's say I want to go to floor 3. So I'll go ahead and set floor 3, bling, and it turns green. Notice that. Okay, and the other one turned red. So we're not going anywhere else except floor 3. All right, let's say I'm on floor 3 now, and I want to go to floor 2. You notice it changed right away. Floor 3 became red, and floor 2 became green. So this is how that works, and it's infinitely expandable, okay? All of this, you can just tack on another one and another one and another one and another one. And you can keep going, keep going, keep going. You could make a zero floor if you wanted to. I don't know why you'd want to, but you can. This setup does allow for it, but you'd have to make it over here somewhere. Okay, so this works, and it's very good. Now, let's say I'm on floor 3, or say I'm on floor 1, rather, and I want to go to floor 2. I've already selected floor 2, and this says I'm going down. So the way you do that is when you step on floor 1, it lets you know, hey, I'm going over there. And you step off and notice it's still saying that. And so now, using these two simple inputs, we can determine what floor we're going to and if we're going up or down. So I just want you to know that the interface is built. And yes, we are working toward building the actual elevator. The elevator is not built. It's kind of built. Let me show you what it does. Okay. So we've got two sides, which is not how the elevator is going to be. You can step on it. It sends you up, and you're up. Then if you want to go down, I have noticed there's two ways to get down. And this one is the most fun, but it is the most dangerous. You go ahead here, go down, and you stop right before you get to the bottom. And there you go. Now, there's another way. There's another way. Let me show you this. It's kind of silly. Okay, so we're there. I didn't want to go all the way up because this is not a normal thing. All right, so I'm up here. I can't actually stop us before we get to the trap door. We're going to be hurt, though, and you'll see why. Creativerse has this really funny system about it. Notice, I didn't hit the bottom. I'm okay, I'm not moving, but ow! It treats it as though I fell from that distance to there because it's messed up. It says, oh, you fell this many blocks before hitting a solid surface. That means you get hurt that much. That's what that is saying. So, we're not going to be able to use that really awesome method to go ahead and let us down. We're going to have to use a system of trapdoors that drop us every 7 blocks, because that's the distance where you won't get hurt, and I'll show you that. All right, so I'm up here. That's 7 blocks down. I didn't get hurt. All right. But this is 8 blocks down. Ow, I got hurt. So there you go. Okay, so 7 blocks, 8 blocks. So we'll have to have a trapdoor that drops us every 7 blocks. So that's too easy because we know how to make us go to what floor and if we're going up or down. It doesn't matter the method. this interface is what's going to make it work for us. So in order to make that work, we're going to have to build what are called latches. And I'll go ahead and build one for you right now. Well, I'll build a couple for you right now. You need a couple of things, though. I know, you always need a couple of things. So let's go ahead and dig out some holes. Actually, let's dig out the holes over here. I made a mess in my yard. I can't believe it. There we go. Okay, the other thing you're going to need. So you got pressure plates. Now you're going to need a couple of logic gates. And we're going to need a couple of LEDs. So there we go. Now I'm going to go ahead and wire this up. But I've also prepared a video instruction on why this works. Okay? So I'm going to show you how to wire it up. But first, please watch the video that I'm about to show you. If you don't understand it by then maybe this next part will help you. But this part will not, you won't understand it unless you watch the video. So watch that first, and then we'll come back to this. Okay? I'll wait for you. Okay, YouTubers, the first SR latch we're going to talk about is the NOR SR latch, which requires two NOR gates. Now, in order for this to work, what you do is take the output of the first NOR gate and you add it to the input or one of the inputs of the second NOR gate. Then you take that second NOR gate's output and put it into the input of the first NOR gate. Okay, so it's a little cross-wired there. Okay, what this is going to give us is this is going to give us a set and a reset. Okay, so now that we've got a set and a reset, our outputs are going to be Q and not Q. Sometimes it's drawn with a line over it. My keyboard doesn't do that, so yeah, you're stuck with the Q prime, but it's still the same. It's Q naught. Okay, the initial state of this latch is going to have a false on both of the circuits. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and add a set false and a reset false. All right, the other thing we're going to add is we're going to have the first circuit being true. Okay, and that's going to make Q also true. All right, this is what's called the set state. All right, the set state. The other thing we're going to do is that's going to make circuit 2 false, which is going to make Q naught also false. Okay, so now Q naught is false, Q is true, and our latch is set. Okay, so this is the set state. And one way that you know this is the set state is if you add a set signal. So let's just, you know, for giggles, let's go ahead and make set true. Okay, and the way we're going to do that is we're going to also add a set true to this. So let's go ahead and do that. Boom, there we go. So we're going to add a true pulse. And what that's going to do is it's a NOR gate. So that means that, and if you don't know, you should, because we've already done this in one of the tutorials, is that if you have two true inputs on a NOR gate, you're going to get a false output. So that still makes this situation in a state which is still the set state. Because if you have a false on the reset, so let's go ahead and do that. Right here, your false on the reset, and your false coming out of Q naught, that's still going to give you a true output on that first NOR gate. Okay, so this is still a set latch. Okay, still a set latch. All right, so let's go ahead and we'll go ahead and remove the true pulse right here, okay? And we'll give it false, so that means that this is going to have to be false, right? The circuit will have to be false. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, and that is still able to do this because if you have one true and one false, that's still going to be a false output on the NOR. You're going to have a false input on the reset, a false input coming from Q naught. And that's going to give you a true because it's a not or, and that's still a good statement here. Okay, so let's go ahead and reset. Let's reset this gate or this latch. So in order to reset it, we need to go ahead and give the reset a true pulse. Okay, so we got to do that. So let's go ahead and give this a true pulse. That means that we're going to have to go ahead and give this a true wire. And now if you have a true and a false on a NOR gate, you're going to go ahead and get a false output. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to give that a false output. Now our set has, or our bottom NOR gate has a false and a false, and that's going to yield a true coming out of the NOR gate. So let's go ahead and do that. All right. And if we have that, that's going to make, well, we already forgot to make Q is going to be false, right? And Q naught is going to be true. There you go. So that's how that works. Now, if we remove the reset pulse, because right now it's still a good statement. So let's remove the reset pulse and we'll make that a false. Then we'll go ahead and come over here and we'll make that a false wire. There we go. And that's still a good statement there. Okay? So that's our reset state for the NOR latch. Now the NOR latch has one problem. And its problem is that both inputs cannot be true at the same time. Okay? Meaning the set and reset cannot be true. If you do that, you're going to end up with a bad state on your latch. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So let's go ahead and pulse in a true for the reset. And let's go ahead and for our set, where is that? That's where I was looking for it. Let's go ahead and give that a true. Okay. So let's get those wires being true. So we've got two true statements right there. Now we've got an issue that we're going to have here. Okay, let's go ahead and start with the reset. All right, so first off, if you have true and true, it's a NOR, so that's going to be false. All right, which is good. Then we're going to have a true and a false. It's a NOR gate, so that means that's got to be false. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's change that to false. There we go. So we've got a false there. Oh, and Q naught is going to be false. There you go. So now what you've ended up with is you've ended up with a state in which both outputs are not good, meaning you don't have a latch set right now. Okay, so you can't make both of them true. Now, if you remove one of them, then you're going to go ahead and you're going to go ahead and set your state. So having a true on both the set and reset will yield a false false for your latch, meaning your latch is no longer set. Not at all. It's not set or reset. So this is a null state. This is an invalid statement. Okay, so that's the NOR latch, the NOR SOR latch in its graphical form. I know it's a little dry. I hope you were able to follow that. Next up, we'll go ahead and talk about the NAND latch. Okay, YouTubers, now we're going to go ahead and talk about the other type of SR latch, which is the NAND latch. It's built pretty much the same, but we're going to go ahead and do some different things. I'll go ahead and fill you in as we go. So for a NAND latch, we're going to need NAND gates. So that's why we've got two NAND gates there. Now we're going to go ahead and set these up pretty much the same. So we're going to take the output from the first one, and we're going to throw it to the input of the second one. We're going to take the output of the second one and throw it to the input of the first one. So that looks all the same. So far, so good. We're going to still have our reset on top, and we're still going to have our set on the bottom. Now I'm going to throw you a curveball. Our Q naught, our reset, is going to be on top. Our Q, our set, is going to be on bottom. This is a big difference. Please pay attention. If it doesn't work, this is probably one of the reasons why. So refer back to said Q and Q naught positioning. Okay, the next thing that is very, very different is that a NAND latch likes to remain powered, whereas the NOR latch does not need it. So with the NAND latch, you need to have your inputs being true. So let's go ahead and get those set up. So we're going to go ahead and give us, not that, we want this one. There we go. True and true. So that's going to go ahead and make that true, and it's going to make that true. So now we've got reset and set being true. All right, let's go ahead and get this thing set up so that it is actually in a set state. So we'll go ahead and give that a true. There we go. So now that one is true for set. And then we're going to have our reset being false. So that's going to make our Q not false and our Q true. There we go. We now have a set NAND latch. Now, the way this works, if you look at the reset NAND gate, you'll see that it's getting two true inputs. And for a NAND, two true means false. Everything else is going to deliver a true output. Again, if you're confused on that, I have a tutorial for that. You should have watched it. I'll wait for you. Don't worry. Okay, I've waited long enough. I hope you watched it all. Anyway, going on to the set NAND gate, you'll see that it's getting a false and a true. And like I said, anything else is a true. So there you go. Now, we're going to go ahead and reset this thing. Now, remember, on the NOR latch, you had to power one of the inputs in order to make it reset or set. With the NAND latch, you will unpower one of the inputs to make it set or reset. So in this case, we want to reset it. So we're going to go ahead and unpower the reset. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to go ahead and unpower that, giving it a false. That's going to go ahead and give that a false. And that's going to go ahead, and now we have a false and a true. A false and a true is going to give us a true in a NAND gate. So let's go ahead and give that a true. That's going to make Q not true. Why is Q not true? Haha, get it? Why is Q not true? Sorry, bad digital joke. That gives our set latch, our set NAND gate rather, two true, which is going to give us a false. So let's go ahead and do that now. So that's going to deliver a false there. That's going to make Q false. There we go. And now everybody's happy because two false for the reset gate is a true. So that all works. That is a reset NAND latch. But we're going to go ahead and repower it and it shouldn't change, right? Right. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to go ahead and repower our reset. There we go. And we're going to repower our reset. Perfect. And that's still a good statement because a true and a false and a NAND gate equals a true. So there you go. Now, how do we go ahead and set it back again? Well, that's quite easy. We're going to go ahead and remove the true from our set. So let's go ahead and do that. And we'll make that a false. We're going to go ahead and give that a false there. And that is going to give us a false and a true, and a NAND gate that is a true. So let's go ahead and give us a true there. That's going to make Q true. So why are you, there you go, Q is now true. So now our reset gate is now getting two trues, which is going to give us a false. So that's going to give us an output of false. So let's do that. There you go. And that's going to make our Q not false, which sounds really weird when you say it like that, but it's false. So Q not is false. So now we've got that two falses on our set, and that's fine because that'll still give us a true, so everybody's happy. Let's go ahead and bring our true back as if we didn't hit the switch anymore. There we go. And now let's go ahead and make our set true. Perfect. So the NAND latch, just like the NOR latch, has a problem. The NOR latch's problem is that it didn't like both of them to be powered at the same time, meaning reset and set cannot both be true at the same time. But in the NAND latch, it's the opposite. It says, I don't want set and reset to be false. If we do that, we're going to end up with another null state. So let's try it, but it's going to be different. You'll like it. It's fun. Okay, let's go ahead and try, see what happens. So let's go ahead and make our set false. Let's do that real quick. Where is set? Set, there you are. Oops, there you go. Set is now false. Let's go ahead and make set false there. Let's go ahead, and that's still a true, so that's good. Now let's go ahead and make our reset false. So where's reset? Reset, where are you? There you are. Reset false, reset false. So there we go. Now, what's that gonna give us? Well, that's gonna give us a true. So that's no good. So let's go ahead and do that. So that's gonna set that to be true, which is gonna make Q not true, which is right there. And now we have our problem, because now the reset and the set are both false, but we have a false and a true input, which gives us a true. We have a true and a false input, which gives us a true. So now our Q and our Q not are both true. Remember in the NOR gate, they ended up being both false. In the NAND, I'm sorry, the NOR latch, they would both end up to be false if both inputs were true. In the NAND latch, if both inputs are false, both outputs are true. So there you go. That's a huge, huge thing. So we end up with another bad situation, or they call it a legal operation, or any number of words that you could come up with. Anyway, this is not situation desired. Unless this happens to be what you're going for, in which case, okay, cool, got it. All right, so I hope that was a little easier to understand than simply just building it. And if it wasn't, I really can't break it down any easier than that. That's about as good as I can get it, I'm sorry. I mean, other than throwing some truth tables up on the screen, which you probably won't care about anyway. That's about as easy as I can make it graphically. I might be able to break it down a little easier one-on-one, like little questions and things. So if you do have those kinds of questions, go ahead and leave those in the comments, and I'll do my absolute best to try to answer them. I swear, I will. If I don't, I'm sorry in advance, but I'll do my best. All right, so that's NAND and NOR latches. Now back to the actual Creativerse show. Okay, and I hope that you've understood everything that you've just watched, and we're going to go ahead and set this up. So we're going to do the NOR latch first, okay? So we'll come over here to our logic gate. We'll press N, and we'll turn this into a NOR gate. All right, and don't worry about the inputs or outputs yet. All right, we'll come over here, press N, and do NOR again. Okay, we know that these are going to be our outputs, so let's go ahead and set our outputs for the LEDs. Now, we also know that the output of one goes to the input of the other. So we'll go ahead and set that over there. The output of this one will go to the input of this one. Okay, there we go. We've got a natural state for this. So let's go ahead and put our sin from our switch over here and our sin for our switch over there. Excellent. So now, what are we looking at? Well, if I step on this plate, it changed to over here. And if I step on this plate, it changes to over there. This is our SR latch right here. This is our SR NOR latch. Look how easy that was to set up. It just required 6 components. All right, 2 to actually make the logic work. 2 for display and 2 for input. That's it. That's all these are right here. These are just those SR latches right here. So that's all this is. It's not that hard, people. Now, we can easily, because this is Creativerse, turn this into a NAND latch. And we do that by coming over here, doing NAND and save, and coming over here and doing NAND and save. Now, you witness right here what happened, because you already know what happened because you watched the video. If you have 2 false on a NAND, you're going to end up with 2 being on. So the way we fix that is we're going to add some switches. We're going to come over here. And one thing, if you'll notice, this is a little trick that I like to use. If you highlight over the input or output that you're interested in, if you notice in your little blue tool, your screen there, it actually goes ahead and highlights that also in green. So we know that we need to get rid of output two. So we'll select that, delete, hit save, and it should go away. The other output input we want to get rid of is this one. So we get rid of that, delete, and there. Totally did that wrong. Let me try that again. I was highlighting the correct one, and I totally selected the wrong one. Input one is the one we want to get rid of. There we go, input one, and that went away. Now, let's bring our switches over. All right, our switches come over. Now, let's go ahead and turn them on. There we go. Now, in order to reset this, we turn one off, turn it on, turn one off, turn it on. See how that works? So in this case, this one is changing this one's state, which is how it should be. This one's changing this one's state, which is how it should be. See how that works? That's our NAND latch. So with them powered, we actually can set it. And then now if we switch them back to NOR, we can witness the other problem that we were going to have. And both of these will be off because the switches are powered. If we go ahead and unpower them, there you go. Now we've got our set reset back. See how that works? All right. I hope that was clear as mud for all of you. No, I hope it was clear as water because mud is not clear. But I hope you understand the basic principles of how to make a latch and why it's important. Because you need to be able to set the state of something. In our case, we need to know which floor we're going to be on. And we need to know if we're going up or down. We also need to be able to reset those states of up or down or what floor is currently selected. Okay? This is how you actually do digital memory, believe it or not. You are just one step closer to understanding solid state memory. Ooh, don't worry, we're not going to get into that on this one. But the point is, you could understand it. You could probably take a class in it and do very well in it if you understood all of this. So good job, pat yourself on the back. You actually have more knowledge than most of the people in the world. How do you feel? All right, great. I appreciate you joining me and I hope you're following along with these. I know this one might have been a little bit complicated, maybe even a little over your head, and that's fine. As long as you kind of got the basic principle of how this works and why, we'll get into actually building this later, okay? Maybe in the next one, because that would be fun. Well, no, we can't in the next one, because we still don't know how number comparators and number pads work. So that probably will be our next one. So we'll do number pads and number comparators in the next one, so that you actually understand how that part of it works. You've got this part, and then everything else should be easy for you. All right, hey, thank you for watching. I appreciate it, and I hope you're learning something. Until next time, peace.